This video accompanies the discussion of experiments in open interest statistics and introduces the basic principles of experimental design. Experiments are particularly important due to their fundamental role when trying to show a causal connection between two or more variables. In particular, we'll learn about the difference between control groups and treatment groups. We will study methods of randomization and replication, as well as blocking, and we will also consider the importance of blinding and placebos. Consider the common experiment to test whether a particular pill is effective at treating a specific medical condition. In such experiments, volunteers are randomly placed into two study groups. One group, the treatment group, receives the drug, and the other group, called the control group, does not receive any drug treatment, though they may receive a placebo. The most basic analysis is then to compare the outcomes of volunteers in the control group to those in the treatment group. However, there are a handful of important considerations to ensure the data are as valid and helpful as possible. First, we consider randomization and replication. Randomization and replication reduce bias and uncertainty. Researchers randomize patients into treatment groups to account for variables that cannot be controlled. Additionally, the more cases researchers can observe, the more accurately they can estimate the effect of the explanatory variable on the response. In a single study, we replicate by collecting a sufficiently large sample. Next, let's consider blocking. To do so, suppose we are looking at the effect of a specific drug on heart attacks. We might first divide patients into low-risk and high-risk blocks. Then we can divide each block evenly into the treatment groups using randomization. This strategy, known as blocking, ensures an equal representation of patients in each treatment group from both the low-risk and high-risk categories. Lastly, we'll consider the importance of blinding and placebos. To circumvent psychological effects among study participants, researchers prefer the patients not know which group they are in. When researchers keep the patients uninformed about their treatment, the study is said to be blind. A fake treatment is called a placebo, and an effective placebo is the key to making a study truly blind. Oftentimes, a placebo results in a slight but real improvement in the patients. This effect has been dubbed the placebo effect. In this video, we learned about differences between control groups and treatment groups, and we studied principles of experiments, including randomization, replication, blocking, blinding, and placebos. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend and visit openintro.org for more resources.